Hi guys, this is Deja coming to you again with another video. As I stated in my last one, I was gonna do a live regarding Young Dolph. As you guys know, he died a few days ago, and I wanted to send my condolences over to the family because I know how hard it is to lose somebody that's really close to you, and he seemed like a really good husband and father outside of his rap life. So yeah, I just want to send my condolences over to the wife and his kids and his family. When he died, I listened to, some of his music, but I wasn't really, a die-hard fan. But there was a few songs that I liked by him, and they got me through some, pretty tough times. Like, as far as, like, Preach, like, and it's so funny because the day before he died, that song, I listened to it, like, 4 or 5 times that day. And little did I know, the next day he was gonna die. I honestly didn't know him as a person, but when I got the news, something just dawned on my spirit, and it was heavy. It was a heavy, dark feeling, and it just made me wanna, look a little bit deeper into his creativity, the music he put out, the kind of energy he had around him before his passing. And people express themselves through their music, their videos and stuff. So it just made me want to go back, down his videos and see what kind of signs or any type of message, that he gave, resulting, into something like this. Because I firmly believe people get signs of things before they happen. And this song here, Talking to My Scale, it kind of resonated with, something leading to destruction. If you ask me, this is just my personal opinion after watching his video. So I just wanted to make a video, discussing my perception of what I see and, the imagery that was placed in his videos. And it's kind of disturbing. It's really disturbing because he came out with this 2 months ago, and it made me think, did he know something was going to happen to him before it happened? And I just wanted to go ahead and watch it with you guys and see, give you my personal aspect of he knew something was going to happen. So let's go. As you see, he started the video off with the all-seeing eye and the pyramid. This is occult symbolism all day, every day. And it says paper route Illuminati. As you guys know, Illuminati is a secret society that is basically controlled by Willy Wonka. When I say Willy Wonka, that, abbreviates the government. It's basically a secret society. So it just makes me think, did he sell his soul, or did he have any type of connections and ties to them? I feel he did, which is why he put so many imagery in his, in his creativity. As you can see, he got the all-seeing eye in the middle, and it's, the eye is red. So maybe, he was telling us that, this is a blood sacrifice, and he was just trying to project it out so people can see, they could know exactly what happened to him through his music. If you go back and you look at his videos, his last album, it said Paper Route Illuminati. And I'm pretty sure that was planted. That was planted there for a reason. You know, I don't want people to, you know, get distracted, you know, with the street beef, because it's fine. You can see it right here in front of, you know, in front of your eyes through his videos of who he was basically, you know, who he was against, who he was with. You know, you can see it all through his creativity. So that was the first, you know, sign that I got when I watched this video. That was like a no-no. It was like, oh, wow. The story takes a turn. So here's another part here where he's projecting himself to be in hell. And then he give like this stare as, you know, as a fed up, like he was fed up and tired of something, like something was sitting on his, you know, his soul, his chest. And it just looked like he was fed up. He was in a really dark place by it all. And it just looked like he was in a dark place, and he was just tired of like all of the things he was basically going through and the kind of energy, the people he had around him. He just looked like he was ready to give everybody hell when it comes down to his life. And he put himself in hell. He projected himself to be in hell, you know, where people go there when they're damned forever. They're damned. It's just all bad, you know. Fuck everybody, fuck every time, nigga. Keep running, nigga. Run this shit up. And as you guys just also seen as well, he, you know, he put the crosses in there and they were like red, fire red and shit. So that was another symbolism as well, because, you know, Jesus died on the cross to pay for all of our sins. And here he go, projecting himself in hell with the crosses. And that's like predictive programming, because Jesus died on the cross. So if you got these imageries, you know, in your videos and, you know, blood and, you know, fire, all it's going to do is lead to nothing but destruction. So maybe he knew, you know, something was going to happen before it happened. And he just had to, like, put out there. Or maybe he was forced. Maybe he was forced to put all this occult, you know, symbolism in his work, in his creativity. Because maybe they knew his time was coming, or something was pre-planned or whatever. I'm not really sure, but one thing I do know is people get signs. Excuse me. People get signs about things before they happen. Because I've encountered a lot of situations like that where, you know, I'll be like, oh, don't do this. You know, something might happen. Then the next, you know, I do it and it turns out bad. But I knew beforehand that, like, something was going to happen. So I honestly feel, you know, he knew something dark, something, you know, devilish was gonna happen to him. Nigga, running shit all the way up, nigga, till you can't run it no motherfucking more, nigga. All the way up, nigga. Fuck off, nigga, to the motherfucking ceiling, nigga. Fuck these bitches. Fuck these niggas too. Fuck them all. You know what I mean? I mean this shit. For real, nigga. Straight up. Hey. If I sacrifice myself, will I go to hell? And then he said, if I sacrifice myself, will I go to hell? So maybe maybe it was his time to sacrifice something or somebody, and he said he'll sacrifice himself. I'm not really into the whole secret society thing. I don't know the things they have to go through, you know, to get to the level of success that they are. But one thing I am firm on, I am a great investigator. And as I stated, people show their creativity through their art. And you got so many rappers, so many artists, so many actors doing the same occult symbolisms, and some of them died, you know, and some of them are still here. And once you look at the mental state of these people, you know, how they project themselves to be is that they're okay, you know, nothing's wrong. But behind closed doors, we don't really know what these people are going through. We can only go based on the things they show us. And all throughout this video is nothing but occult symbolism. So he's directing this message to maybe a secret society, the record label, you know, the government, whoever, that somebody, he's signaling that somebody is targeting him. And it could be the Illuminati. It was his turn to pay his debt, or to, you know, maybe make his sacrifice, or I don't know. It was time for him to give up something, and he chose to give up himself. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. Like, these people put it out themselves. So it's not like, you know, we're seeing this and we really don't know. These people are putting out the imagery themselves as clues. And you have other artists that did the same thing, and they ended up passing away afterwards. So now it's not really more, say, a conspiracy now, because so many artists are doing the same imagery. It's just with Young Dolph's situation, he passed away afterwards. So to me, this is all predictive programming. He knew something was going to happen to him. And, you know, it's funny because in his last stages, he, you know, started to expose, you know, let it be blunt when it comes down to, you know, the symbolism. And I'm like, out of all the videos, you know, I've seen of him, his last album, it's like he was pushing all of this, like, even harder. And it just makes me wonder, like, did they force him or put him under some type of MK Ultra to make him come out and do this stuff? Because he's basically giving praise to the devil, to the people, you know, that are actually causing all of this confusion on the planet. You know, I don't know, guys. Let me finish playing the movie, because I'll talk and then we'll be talking for like 20 minutes, you know, without getting back to the topic. So let me play the music.
In my trap house counting guala, talking to my scale. My jewelry box having more water than Wisconsin Dales. Trap nigga, I count money better than I spell. Came up from nothing, addicted to hustling. Yeah, he my dog, but now I don't trust him. She a bad bitch, but she know we just fucking. She told me she love me, I told her you pluckin'.
Cut that shit out, Lamar.
Stop it. This bitch deserve a gold medal the way she suck it.
Shit.
Blue Louis V bucket. Yeah. My train too big to tuck.
Oh, I just noticed something too on the necklace.
Trap nigga, I count money better than I spell. Came up from nothing, addicted to hustling. Yeah, he my dog, but now I don't trust him. She a bad bitch, but she know we just fucking. She told me she love me, I told her you pluck it.
Cut that shit out, Lamar.
Stop it. This bitch deserve a gold medal the way.
Okay, so let's see if I can zoom in. Okay, so on the medals they have around their neck. Oh, don't change. Wait a minute, guys. I just okay, there we go. So it looks like on the gold chains they have around their neck, well, the medals, it looked like it has the pyramid symbol. I can see it a little bit, but it's most definitely a pyramid. So that's another sign, you know, of who he's redirecting this whole energy and video to. So he's standing in front of, you know, a girl, and she has the, you know, pyramid, you know, over one of her eyes, and she's standing in back of him. So it's like he got, you know, he's holding this all, you know, in back of him or on his shoulders or whatever, and it's all occult symbolism.
Size of biggest spinning paper like I'm puffy. Yeah. She fucked me, then she lucky. Yeah, she got this super sloppy. I call that bitch yucky. Bitch, don't speak to me in public. Bitch, fast money, fast cars. I live for this shit. Bitch, my young nigga and them ain't they gon' kill for this shit. Bitch, shaking my head off. You just too real for this shit. Bitch, my first investment was a vehicle seal. Then I got rich. Bitch, Nemo can't get whatever from me cause he never switched. Name it. Jizzle was right there with me, man. We didn't have shit. Sleeping cuz quick to tell me fuck him, he a bitch. Fuck him. Dog ass nigga off the leash, duck in the pitch. Went and found out the plug, came back and told my nigga it's up. We gon' ball forever and forever straight out the mud. Hey. Been through so much shit, so I fill my body up with drugs. 20 whips in front of the club, nigga, that's us. On my own stylish, I spend millions on designers. I got my own island, and can't stay here, you can find me. Got more jewelry than your jeweler, nigga, I spent millions on diamonds. I put ice on everybody around me just to see them shining. Yeah, yeah. My spot got great customer service like Chick-fil-A. Yeah. Might take her to the hood, but I can't take her on a date. Yeah. Sleep walking on that codeine, but I'm wide awake. Yeah. These niggas ain't fucking with me, and I put that on item, man. Yeah, yeah.
Also, he had a bag like full of money, and then, you know, it goes into the bag, but it jumps straight to him going to hell, you know. So that's like, you know, he's going through this, all of this, all because of the money. Everything he went through, you know, him passing, I'm pretty sure was all because of the money. And in one of the other videos, he was saying, you know, he got, you know, a deal to take 22 million, and he was like, forget the 22 million, and basically, you know, saying that he's good with, you know, the amount of money he have now. So he declined that offer. So maybe, you know, this video here has a lot of meaning, because he basically did get, you know, killed over money. You know, he had distributions and stuff with, you know, Empire Records. And, I mean, he didn't specifically say who offered him that deal, but he is, you know, signed through Empire Records. So I'm assuming maybe, you know, when he said he had a deal, it was referring to them. But, you know, he basically died for the money. He was sacrificed for money.
Oh, you know what I mean? I had to figure this shit out, nigga. You know what I mean? Just me and my real nigga, you know what I mean? Nigga, you ain't eat out the flow with us, nigga. You ain't eat out the garbage with us, nigga. You know what I mean? You wasn't there, nigga. You wasn't there with us, nigga. We had to get it how we live, nigga. I put that shit on out of me.
Nah, I ain't finished, nigga. Yeah, yeah. My office is a trap house in South Memphis, nigga. Yeah, yeah. Riding with a bullet through the city, nigga. Yeah, yeah. I been selling bags about a 50, nigga. Yeah, yeah. Pinky ring, it cost me $750, nigga. Yeah, yeah.
pour it, ate it, drank it, I don't sip it, nigga.
Yeah.
Kicking shit and smoking, I'm forbidden, nigga.
Hey, bro.
You a grown man, stop all of that bitching, nigga.
Damn.
I go so hard, make them hate me.
Damn.
My whole life a movie, HD.
Yeah.
Blue retro, blue AP.
Yeah.
Too much ice, don't need AC.
Nah.
Had to put out, this bitch had to rape me. I wear water, I'm drinking, I drink lean.
Bro.
I pull lean and grapefruit juice and rock blue diamonds. Now these niggas ain't me.
Sixes on a double R. Look up at the stars.
In the clouds.
Smoking Skittles and thanking God. Remember I used to starve. Dope boy with dope boy dreams. Never thought I'd make it this far. 14, I jumped out there, started swimming with the sharks. Gang bang, play some ball, go get a plug or rock. I got the type of ice that it go crazy in the dark. You put your trust in a bitch, I put my trust in the mob. I got all type of shit parked in the garage.
Hey,
hey!
Okay, so the question is, since he sacrificed himself, did he go to hell? And through his imagery and his projection, was it worth it? You know, it's too late to ask him this question now. But I hope this is like, you know, a wake-up call for, you know, all the other rappers and even regular people like, you know, you and me that watch this kind of stuff. This was a clear as day message that he gave, you know, regarding, you know, the music industry and the kind of things that they're involved in and all kinds of things. We don't know how this kind of, you know, stuff will affect us, affect our brains, our energy. We don't really know the kind of world we're creating in our heads and in our environment. And what makes it worse, this stuff is not PG-13 for your kids. And now we got little kids being exposed to this kind of imagery and they have no clue what, you know, what these people, these rappers have to go through. And I just want, you know, people to be mindful and just wake up to our surroundings and pay attention to, you know, what people say, the things they do, because everything we do have a meaning and it's done on purpose. It's like our lives, you know, it's like predictive programming. What we watch, what we eat, what we say reflects on our future. And most of these people just don't realize that. They don't realize it until, you know, until it's the end and people like us, you know, have to sit and talk about it for them to bring some type of justice and clarity on their life because they couldn't figure it out before they passed. And I just, you know, I just want us to wake up as a, you know, as a whole species or, you know, a whole group, because we have to come together and we have to come together to make change. And we're losing a lot of good people due to the industry, due to gun violence, due to confusion and manipulation that was pre-planned for us to be that way. So I just wanted to send like my condolences, you know, to the family and pay my respects to Young Dolph, because, you know, I got through watching his video, I got his message. And it's sad to say, you know, this has happened to other people, other rappers as well. And they gave their signs and messages through their music before they died. So I just wanted to pay my respects to him and let him know I understand. And I thank you for the wake up call, you know, that he gave me. Because if it wasn't for him dying and me feeling what I felt, I wouldn't have had the courage to come out and to make, you know, a video regarding him. He kind of hit me a little bit different than the other rappers and stuff. So he was, you know, a unique soul. We won't ever get anyone else like him. We can get, you know, someone close, but as far as, you know, Adolph Thornton, we won't ever get anyone else like him. So I just wanted to pay my respects, you know, to him and the family, even though I didn't know him. And to be honest, I only knew a few of his songs. I wasn't, a diehard fan, but after his passing, it woke me up to go out and get my, you know, to speak my mind and get my messages across. Because now is the time for us to connect and come together and start, you know, revealing all of the dark deeds that go on behind closed doors that we're missing and we're not really paying attention to. People's souls are screaming out for answers and help. And I want to be one of the reasons why, you know, people find clarity and find peace in this crazy world. You know, we have to start being problem solvers and investigators to be able to, you know, pinpoint, you know, all this dark energy, this dark matter. It's a whole different subject, but this video here is directly towards Young Dolph and his passing and how I feel it was symbolic, and he gave a direct message of why he was killed and why he was sacrificed. So thank you guys. If you like this video, go ahead and like it and subscribe to my channel. Thank you and God bless.